Hello students, welcome to the video lecture 2 on the topic fundamental concepts and definitions. So in the previous class we have studied what do you mean by thermodynamics, what are the types of thermodynamics studies, for example classical thermodynamics and statistical thermodynamics, which are also known as the macroscopic approach and microscopic approach of thermodynamics. Then we have studied applications, and afterwards we have studied what do you mean by system, boundary, surroundings, and we have studied the different types of systems, that is closed system, open system and the isolated system. And we have studied the examples of these three systems. So in the today's class we will cover the topics properties of the system and its types, state of the system, equilibrium of the system, what do you mean by process and path of the system, finally what do you mean by quasi-static and non-quasi-static processes. So properties of the system. See, what do you mean by property? Any characteristic of a system, it is called as the property of the system. So in this properties of the system, see, these are the examples of the properties. It may be pressure, volume, temperature, mass, viscosity, electrical resistance, thermal conductivity, etc. See, intensive properties are those properties that are independent of the size of the system or mass of the system. Intensive properties are those properties which are independent of the mass of the system or size of the system. So here examples we have shown here wrong. So actually pressure, temperature, density, these are the examples of the intensive properties of the system. Whereas next, extensive properties are those properties whose value depends on the mass of the system or on the size of the system. We can show here velocity, maybe elevation, mass, volume, etc. These are the examples for the extensive properties of the system. And next one is the specific properties. The extensive properties per unit mass, these are called as the specific properties. For example, specific volume, we are denoting it by small v, that is volume per unit mass, it is called as the specific property, specific volume, specific enthalpy. So just enthalpy we are denoting it by capital H. So enthalpy per unit mass, it is nothing but specific enthalpy, we are denoting it by small h. So this is about the properties. So I will give you the example for this with the help of sketch. See here, now let us define these intensive and the extensive properties by considering this block diagram. See, if we'll consider this as one room or one block. So if this block, it is having, if this entire block, it is having some mass, it is having some volume, it is having temperature, it is having pressure, it is having some density. So if this entire block or room, if it is divided into two parts, here in this part mass gets divided, that means here half mass will be there on the other side half mass will be there. Volume, here also volume will be half here in this portion. If I will divide this entire block into two parts, so here I will get half mass, half volume, here I will get half volume, here I will get half mass, here also I will get half mass. But temperature, if the room is divided into two parts, here also I am getting the same temperature, here also I am getting the same temperature, here also I am getting same pressure, here also I am getting same pressure, here also I am getting same density, here also I am getting same density. For that purpose, we have defined intensive properties are those properties that are independent of the size of the system, whereas extensive properties are those properties whose value depends on the size of the system. You can see here these properties, these are depending on the size of the system. And the extensive properties, these are denoted by capital letters or uppercase letters except this mass m. Only mass we are showing it by small m, otherwise all other extensive properties are denoted by the uppercase letters, whereas intensive properties are denoted by the lowercase letters except this temperature and pressure. So only temperature and pressure we are showing it by the capital letters, lest all other properties are denoted by the small or lowercase letters for the intensive properties. So intensive properties, boiling point of water, color, hardness, we can give the examples for that. And extensive properties, weight also we can give the example for the extensive properties. So now next we will study what do you mean by state and equilibrium. So first we will consider state. See, consider a system, consider a system, or first let me define what is meant by state. A set of properties to completely describe the condition of the system, it is known as its state. The properties, a set of properties, it may be a mass, temperature, pressure, volume, all these, a set of properties to completely describe the condition of the system is known as its state. So now we will elaborate it. So consider, let us consider a system which is not undergoing any change. It is not undergoing any change. At this point, all the properties of the system can be measured throughout the entire system, which gives us a set of properties that completely describes the condition or the state of the system. Now, this is state one. I will call it as a one state. So it is giving some set of properties to describe the condition of the system. That is mass, it is having 2 kg. Temperature, it is having 25 degree centigrade. Volume, it is having 1 meter cube. Pressure, it is having 1 bar. Like this way, it gives us the set of properties to completely describe the condition of this system. So at a given state, or at a given state, if any one of the property changes, then the system, then the state of the system will change to a different one. We can see here, mass here is 2 kg, here also mass is 2 kg, temperature here is 25, here also temperature is 25 degree centigrade, but volume here it is 1 meter cube, volume here it is 3 meter cube. Then we will not tell that the system is under the same state. If any one in the state, if any one of the property changes, then the state of the system will change to a different one. For that purpose, I will call it as the system is at state 1 and the system is at state 2. If any one of the property changes. So even here also, if it is volume 1 meter cube only, then we will tell that both the systems are at the same state. But here, any one property, whether if mass has changed, volume, let volume remains 1 meter cube only, if temperature has changed 26 degree centigrade, even though the 1 degree centigrade it has raised, we will call it as the system is at different state. So now, next we will study, what do you mean by equilibrium? See, this equilibrium, it implies a state of balance. In an equilibrium, there are no unbalanced potentials or driving forces within the system. There are no any driving forces within the system. If driving forces are there, then we will not call it is an equilibrium. So everything is calm here. No unbalanced potentials. Everything it is balanced state. A system which is in equilibrium, it experiences no changes when it is isolated from the surroundings. A system which is in equilibrium, it experiences no any changes. So when it experiences no any changes, when it is isolated from the surroundings. Isolated means there is no any mass and energy entering the system or leaving outside the system. Only when it is isolated from the system, a system which is in equilibrium, it experiences no any changes. But it should be an isolated condition when it is isolated from the surroundings. If it is not isolated, then again mass and energy may transfer from the surroundings to the system, then the system may not be in the equilibrium state. So here we are going to study four types of equilibriums. So mainly as per your syllabus, only three equilibriums are there. So first one is thermal equilibrium. A system is said to be in thermal equilibrium if the temperature is the same throughout the system, or there is no any temperature gradient throughout the system. The meaning of gradient is variation. That means there is no any temperature variation throughout the system. So if I will consider this entire this thing, it has one block. So if I will measure temperature here, it should show same temperature. If I will measure temperature here, it should read same temperature. If I will measure temperature here, the temperature should be same. If I will measure temperature here, it should read same. If I will measure temperature here, it should read same. If I will measure temperature here, it should read same. That means any point in the system, if I will measure the temperature at any point, there should not be any temperature gradient throughout the system. That means the temperature should be same throughout the entire system. If the temperature here it is showing 20 degree centigrade, at this corner the temperature is 25, at this end it is 20, at this end it is 30 degree centigrade, then we will not call that system, it is not in a thermal equilibrium. Thermal equilibrium, that means the temperature should be same throughout the entire system. Next, similarly, we'll study next mechanical equilibrium. A system is said to be in mechanical equilibrium if there is no any change in pressure at any point of the system with time, or there is no any pressure gradient throughout the system. In the same way here also, at any point within the system, the pressure should read the same pressure at all the points within the system. So at one end pressure is different, at other end pressure is different, then we will not call the system is in mechanical equilibrium. When we will tell that the system is in mechanical equilibrium, then the pressure should remain same throughout the entire system. There should not be any pressure gradient. A phase equilibrium. Similarly, So system having more than one phase or mass of each phase is in equilibrium, then it is called as the phase equilibrium. So last one we are going to study, chemical equilibrium. So a system is said to be in chemical equilibrium if its chemical composition is constant or there is no any reaction taking place, no reaction occurs, and its chemical composition, it should not change with the time, then we are calling it as the chemical equilibrium. Now lastly, a system will be in equilibrium unless all the equilibrium criteria are satisfied. When we will tell that the system will be in equilibrium, when this thermal equilibrium, mechanical equilibrium and chemical equilibriums are satisfied, then we will tell that the system is in thermodynamic equilibrium. So next we will study what do you mean by path and the process. Any change a system undergoes from one equilibrium state to another equilibrium state, it is known as process. A series of states through which the system passes during the process, it is known as path of the process. You can see here, I will call this as a property A, I will call this as the property B. The system is at state 1. In the previous slide, we have shown the example. The system, it was having mass 2 kg, temperature 25 degrees centigrade, volume was 1 meter cube. So, in the next state, what we have shown, volume is 3 meter cube. That means, a series of states through which the system passes during a process, it is known as path of the process. It is one path. So process means any change that a system undergoes from one equilibrium state. So here the system is at one equilibrium state. It is changing from one equilibrium state to another equilibrium state. Then this process, whatever it is going to change from state 1 to state 2, we are calling it as one process. And the series of states through which a system passes during this process, it is known as the path of the process. You can see here, the gas continuously here, the gas is contained in a piston cylinder arrangement. So initially the gas was here at state 1, it was having some volume 3 meter cube, mass was 2 kg, temperature was 25 degrees centigrade. Here the gas is compressed, that means volume has decreased from 3 meter cube to 1 meter cube here, you can see here. That means the system has changed to a different state. So whatever the series of states through which a system is passing, we are calling it as the path of the process. This is my path from state 1 to state 2, it is moving. So this is my path of the process and this is my process. From state 1 to state 2, it is moving means it is my process. To describe a process completely, so here one should specify, or we should specify, the initial and the final states as well as the path it follows. Then only we can describe the process completely. If there is no any initial state and final state, how we will describe the process if it is not having any path also? So here path means it is moving from either from state 1 to state 2 or from state 2 to state 1 and its interaction with the surroundings. Then only we can describe the process completely. So next we'll study what do you mean by this process. So here we are going to study a quasi-static process. It is also called as the quasi-equilibrium process. When a process proceeds in such a manner that the system remains infinitesimally close to an equilibrium state or equilibrium conditions at all the times, it is known as quasi-static or quasi-equilibrium process. So quasi-equilibrium process means it is a very slow compression process. और इट इज अ वेरी स्लो एक्सपेंशन प्रोसेस. क्वाजिस्टेटिक मीन्स इट शुड बी अ वेरी स्लो प्रोसेस, आइदर इट मे बी अ कॉम्प्रेशन और आइदर इट मे बी अ एक्सपेंशन. सो व्हेन द प्रोसेस प्रोसीड्स वेरी स्लोली देन एट ऑल द टाइम्स द सिस्टम इज गोइंग टू रिमेन इन एन इक्विलिब्रियम स्टेट एट ऑल द टाइम. सी हियर, एट अ टाइम टी इक्वल टू जीरो, सो आफ्टर सम 5 मिनट्स एट टी इक्वल टू T1, इफ आई विल मेजर द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ दिस सिस्टम, सो वी आर गोइंग टू गेट द सिस्टम, इट विल बी इन इक्विलिब्रियम. सो इक्विलिब्रियम मीन्स डोंट बी अंडर द इंप्रेशन दैट हियर इनिशियली द वॉल्यूम वॉज सम 5 मीटर क्यूब. सो व्हेन द प्रोसेस इज कॉम्प्रेस्ड, हियर वॉल्यूम इज सम 3 मीटर क्यूब, बट एट दिस स्टेट एट टी इक्वल टू T1 ऑल द प्रॉपर्टीज आर uniform here. Temperature here also it is same, here also it is same, pressure here also it is same, here also it is same, volume also same. That means at each and every time it remains close to an equilibrium conditions at all the times. Suppose now if this the in the piston and the cylinder arrangement here gas is there, so if this gas is compressed suddenly, the whatever the molecules which are present in front of the piston here, when the gas is compressed suddenly, these molecules, gas molecules, they will not have enough time to redistribute themselves inside the container of the inside this container or inside the cylinder portion. So if this gas is compressed very suddenly, then these gas molecules, they will not have enough time to escape themselves or to redistribute or reorder or rearrange themselves. When it is compressed suddenly, the molecules, they will get pile up in front, in a small region in front of the piston, so thus creating a very high pressure near the face of the piston rather than the other side of the cylinder. So here pressure will be very less, here the pressure will be more because of the sudden compression. These gas molecules, they will not have enough time to escape, so they will get pile up in a region, in a small region in front of this piston. So here pressure is going to be created more here in front of the piston in this area. So now we'll tell that the system is not in an equilibrium state, because pressure here is less, here pressure is more. So where pressure is more, definitely here temperature will be also more, then the system remains in, it is not remaining in a thermal equilibrium, then we are going to call it as non quasi-static process or a non quasi-equilibrium process. See here, it is a very slow compression, slowly we are compressing here. In quasi, in non quasi-static, suddenly the gas is compressed here. So the system does not remains, it is a very fast compression process or a very fast expansion process. So here it is called as the non quasi static process. You can see here process path, so from state 1 to state 2 it is shown by the continuous lines, and non quasi static process it is denoted by the dashed lines. Here you can see here for pressure and volume.